Yes, very good morning, children. So well, in the last class, I have started the third chapter, that is fiber to fabric. So in that class, so in the last class, what are the topics that you have learned? So quickly we will revise the topics that we have learned in the last class. So well, I told that the sheep, the yak, the camel. So the next the sheep, goat, camel, yeah. So all these animals now we are going to call it as wool yielding animals in the country. So they are called as wool yielding animals. And these animals will have a very thick coat of hair on their body. So our body is very thick coat of hair in the present. So why they are having the thick coat of hair? Because so that hair which is present on the sheep, goat, animals will have hair present in that. So that hair will traps the hair from the surrounding environment in the air in a trap model. And that hair will prevents the heat going out of that animal body. So animal body in the heat acha open the air to prevent model. So as a result, the heat will retain in the animal's body again retain agutte. So then the animals will feel the warm. So this is why the sheep and that means the wool yielding animals will have a thick coat of hair on their body. So then after that we have discussed that so these wool yielding animals, so they are going to provide the two types of fibers on their provide. So one is the coarse beard hair. So that means coarse beard hair and that tumba rough hair on the beard and that gadda. So that hair will be very rough and that hair now we won't consider as a wool fiber na yield madakke. So now coarse beard hair na consider madu. So we are going to consider the fine soft hair that is present below the skin of the animals. So animal skin below hair present irutha. So that skin as that hairs na namu as a wool yielding process ge namu aa hairs mele namu depend aagutte. So then these sheep will have a different varieties of breeds that are grown in different parts of the country ali avu en maadabodu farm maadabodu. So that breeds na namu en maadthivi select maadutivi. So we are going to select the parents, so which is having a fine soft hair. So parents is the male goat, the male sheep and the female sheep, so which is having a fine soft hair, so that their offsprings will give so that offsprings will have that fine soft hair given. So that's why we are going to select the male and the female sheep as the, which is having a fine soft hair given in maadthivi we select maadthivi. Okay na? So this type of selecting the parents for the offsprings, so offsprings which is having a special characters in the offsprings only obtain maadkodadukoskara, so yen parents na select maadkontivi. So that process na we are going to call it as the selective breeding. Then after that we have discussed that the sheep is not only the source of wool. So sheep are in the stay namge wool obtain agala, even the different animals that is present in the different parts of the country lay present irutha. So they are going to provide the wool for us. So that is a very important topic. So the last I have discussed about the different animals the which are present in different parts of the places are present irutha animals. So these are the things that we have discussed in the last class. Now before going to start the today's topic, here we are going to rear the sheep. So rear antandre palane madodu. So why we are going to rear the sheep? To obtain the wool. So sheep inda namu en maadkobeku, so to obtain the wool na obtain maadkodakoskara we are going to rear the sheep. So then after that what we are going to do, so we are going to cut off the hair from the sheep. So sheep inda en maadthivi cut maadtivi. So to get the fiber, so to get the fiber, then how does this fiber is converted into wool? So ee So really, the very first processing of our brain, that is the rearing and breeding of sheep. So rearing and then I already told that. So pal and model of the. So breeding and then that is the varieties of sheep. So varieties of sheep is now yawriti. So rearing martiri. So we shall learn that first process. Then we shall learn the how to convert that fibers into woolen yarns.
Because
so in winter season only, of course the climatic temperature, so the climatic condition will be very cold, correct? So this is one condition, so that's why they are going to keep the sheep inside the indoors. So
and the last one, so they are going, we shall write the state.
that is Rajasthan, Rajasthan and Punjab. So in Rajasthan and Punjab, we can see the Lohi breed of sheep. So the next two, we shall list out the next type of breed, that is Rampur Basher. So Rampur Basher Bandito, so it is going to give be a what quality of wool provided, that is it is going to give the brown hair. So brown hair, you know, the wools provide. Then in which state in India so we are going to found is, that is Uttar Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh. So we are going to see, that is Rampur Basher. So this is the second type of breed. So the next third one is Nali. So the next type of breed is Nali. So the Nali is going to give, so your type of breeds, your type quality of wool we provide, so it is going to provide the carpet wool. So carpet wool, so that wool this Nali breed sheep provide. And in which places we are going to find this breed means, that is Haryana, Punjab and Rajasthan. So Haryana, Punjab and Rajasthan. So we can see this Nali breeds also. So the next two, the fourth type of breed is that Bakar. So Bakarwal. So this Bakarwal is going to give, so what type of wool provided, that is woolen shawls. So woolen shawls, so that is provided by this Bakarwal breed of sheep provided. And it is found in Jammu and Kashmir. So the next two, here I am going to rub this. So the next type of breed, so the next type of breed, that is fifth one, that is Marwari. So this Marwari breed, so it is going to provide the coarse wool, and the rough wool provide. And it is found in Gujarat. So Gujarat will now find out. So the next, the last one, that is the Pathanwadi. So this Pathanwadi, so what quality of wool it is going to give is housing. So housing means so the socks, so nam kaalagalli socks ela hakuntivala, so that product is provided by the Pathanwadi sheets in the namge. So socks ela madakke use maartaralla aa wool nu, that is we are going to call it as housing and the green. And it is also found in the state, that is Gujarat alli namu find out maadu. So these are the different breeds of sheep and the quality of wool that they are going to give, and the states where we are going to find these types of wools find out. Of course, as a few seconds later I told that these sheep will have a very thick coat of hair on their body. So the body will very thick coat of hair in the presence here. So that hair will provide a very good quality of wool provide. And we can produce in a large quantity, produce. So here, whatever these sheets I have mentioned here, so any breeds of sheets are mentioned, so they are the selective breeds. So they are selective breeds. So then after that, what they are going to do is, so they are going to cut the, or they are going to shave the hairs from the ಶೀಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಂದ ಹೇರ್ಸ್ ನ ಶೇವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ದೆನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್. ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇದನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಫೈಬರ್ ಟು ಊಲ್. ಸೊ ಫೈಬರ್ ಇಂದ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಊಲ್, ಫೈಬರ್ ಇಂದ ಊಲ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಒಬ್ಟೈನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ದ ಊಲ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಫೈನಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಒಬ್ಟೈನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಊಲ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಊಲ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸೊ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಈಗ ಶೇರ್ ಶೀಟ್ಸ್ ಹೇರ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣನೇ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಇಂಟು ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಊಲ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಟ್ ಫೈಬರ್ ಊಲ್ ಫೈಬರ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ದೆನ್ ದಟ್ ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಇಂದ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬೈ ದಟ್ ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಬೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ನಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಶಾಲ್ಸ್ ಸ್ವೆಟರ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಿಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ನಾವು ವಿ ಶಾಲ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಸೊ ಹೌ ದೀಸ್ ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಫೈಬರ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಫೈಬರ್ಸ್ ನ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಶಾಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಒನ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ದ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ನೌ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೈಬರ್ ಇಂಟು ಊಲ್. ಸೊ ಫೈಬರ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಊಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ನ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ದ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ದ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಥ್ರೂ ವಿಚ್ ಸೊ ಅದರ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಇಂಟು ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಫೈಬರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಉಲ್ಲನ್ ಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಟುಡೇ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಶೀಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಶೀಟ್ ಏರ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ದ ಶೀಟ್ ಏರ್ ಸೊ ಈಸ್ ಕಟ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಥಿನ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೀಟ್. ಸೊ ಶೀಟ್ಸ್ ನ ಹೇರ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ವೆವರ್ ದ ಥಿನ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೀಟ್ಸ್ ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಶಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ನ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಶಿಯರಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ವೆರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಶಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದ ಹೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಶೀಪ್ ನ ಹೇರ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಥಿನ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಂದ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹೇರ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಶೇವ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾಡೋದು. ಸೊ ಹೇರ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಸೊ ದ ಥಿನ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ಸೊ ಶೀಪ್ ನ ಒಂದು ಥಿನ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ರಿಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ನ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಶಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಶಿಯರಿಂಗ್, ದ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಥಿನ್ ಲೇಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕಿನ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಮೂವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಶಿಯರಿಂಗ್. ವೆಲ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಶಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಟ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಶೇವ್ ದಟ್ ಹೇರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ಸ್ ಹೇರ್ ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಶೇವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಶೇವಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಹೇರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಮಿಷಿನ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಮಿಷಿನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಬಾರ್ಬರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಟಿಂಗ್ ಶಾಪ್. ಸೊ ಕಟಿಂಗ್ ಶಾಪ್ಸ್ ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಬಾರ್ಬರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೇರ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಸೋರು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಮಿಷಿನ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅದೇ ತರ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಮಿಷಿನ್ಸ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಟು ಶೇವ್ ದ ಹೇರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಆರ್ ಟು ಕಟ್ ದ ಹೇರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಶೀಪ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಂದ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಕೆ. ದೆನ್ ದ ಅನದರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಶೇವ್ ದಟ್ ಹೇರ್ ನ ಶೇವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ cut the hair or shave the hair of the sheep in the hot climatic conditions. Andre bisli irbegadre. So our time only hairs na cut martare. So why they are going to cut or the shave the hairs in that hot climatic condition? Yeah, martare. So because even hot conditions are there, even the sheep can survive itself or it can protect itself body without the coat of air. So tana body alli air illa andrudu tanna tan en maadkobodu protection maadkobodu. So that's why they are going to shave or cut the hair during the hot climatic condition. So in a hot climatic condition idaga, so you know that the sheep's hair, it keeps warm. So hair in the sheep enagirutte warm aagi irutte. So now winter season cut maadibidre, so it cannot survive, adu survive aagakagalli. So if you just cut it in the hot climatic conditions cut maadidra, of course outside temperature enirutte hot irutte. So outside temperature hot idaga, so even without that air illadallu kuda, so sheep enagabodu survive aagu. So that's why they are going to select to shearing process the maadakke, they select the hot climatic condition. Then after this, so iga hairs na cut maadidmele, so that woolen namge we are going to obtain the woolen fibers enagutte obtain agutte. Then that woolen fiber is processed into woolen fiber. So woolen yarns adi en maadtivi process maadtivi. So woolen yarns adi en maadtivi process maadtivi. Okay na? So this is the step one process of the head. So this is the step one process. So the next two question that comes to the mind. So in a shearing process again, I told that, so the hair of the sheep along with the thin layer of the skin is removed. One layer of skin is removed. So this shearing process do not hurt the sheep. So sheep ಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂತ ತೊಂದರೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. So even they are going to remove the one thin layer of the sheep the skin, one layer ತೆಗೆದ್ರು ಕೂಡ, so shearing process ಅಲ್ಲಿ, so the sheep will not get hurt. The reason is ಏನಿದೆ, even we too are going to cut our hairs. So ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಹೇರ್ಸ್ ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. So even our fathers, so our forefathers, they are going to shave the beard. So beard ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, shave ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. So they won't get feel hurt. So hurt ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಹೇರ್ಸ್ ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. So it won't hurt us. The reason is, so when we shave the hairs, the shave ಮಾಡ್ತಾರ, so the uppermost layer of the skin ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ, so that skin is dead skin. So uppermost skin is dead skin ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. So dead skin ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ, so ಈಗ hair cut ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅಥವಾ shave ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು, so ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯಾದಂತಹ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. So even after cutting our hairs, after shaving, so shaving ಎಲ್ಲ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ, so after sometimes again that hair will grow. So ಮತ್ತೆ hair ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, growth ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. So even in sheep's ಕೂಡ, so that cutting shearing process ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ, so after sometimes again the hair will starts growing on the sheep body ಮೇಲೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ hairs ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, growth ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. So that's why shearing process will not hurt the sheep ನ hurt ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ. Because so the uppermost skin ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ, so that skin is dead skin. So that's why it won't hurt the sheep. So this is about the step one process. So in the next class I am going still the process, step two, step three process are there. So I am going to explain it in the next class.